Hello student, today I am going to do class 4 subject SST chapter 6, that is four domains of the earth. In last class we have completed the half chapter. In this class we will continue with the chapter. So let's start. The next topic is ocean. Oceans are large water bodies separated by continents. There are four oceans on the earth. They are all interconnected. In order to size they are Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean and the Arctic Ocean. The water bodies which surrounded the continent of the Antarctica is only an extension of the Pacific, Atlantic and Indian Oceans. The first one is Pacific Ocean. It separates Asia and Australia from North America. It is the largest of all the oceans. It is estimated that it covers an area of about 4,166,884,380 square kilometers, which is greater than the area of all the continents put together. It is not only the largest but also the deepest of all the ocean. Marina Trench in the Pacific Ocean about 11,022 meters deep in the deepest place in the world. The next is Atlantic Ocean. It is separate European and Africa from the North and the South America. It is the busiest ocean in the world as all the important sea routes passes through the Atlantic Ocean. There are many important harbors on its coastal line. Third one, the Indian Ocean. It is the only ocean named after a country, that is India. It lies to the south of India, west of Indonesia and Australia and east of Africa. The fourth one is Arctic Ocean. It surrounded the North Pole and lies within the Arctic Circle. A narrow stretch of water called Bering Strait connects it with the Pacific Ocean. It is bounded by the Russia, Greenland, Canada and Alaska. The next topic is importance of ocean. Ocean provide abundant water vapor to the atmosphere, which result in rain on the plain. Ocean helps in maritime activities and promote trade. These provide an abundant source of food for a mankind. The next is other water bodies. Other water bodies are seas, rivers and lakes. So let's start. Seas are vast water bodies bigger than the river but smaller than ocean. They contain salty water. Most of the river empty into sea and ocean, for example, Mediterranean Sea, Red Sea, Caspian Sea, etc. River. A river is a natural flowing water course, usually fresh water, flowing towards a sea, an ocean, a lake, and another river. A small river joining the big river is called tributary. Important river in India are the Gangas and the Yamunas and the Brahmaputras. The next is lake. A lake is an area of variable size, filled with water and surrounded by land on all sides. There are two types of lakes, saltwater lake and freshwater lake. This is in a picture of a lake. Next is atmosphere. A column of air surrounded the earth up to the height of 1600 kilometers above the earth's surface. It is called the atmosphere. Beyond 1600 kilometers, there is airless outer space. The air is a mixture of gaseous which usually maintain the constant proportion. A sample of air near the earth contains 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen and 1% gaseous such as carbon dioxide, water vapors, etc. On this, oxygen is an important gas. It is called the breath of life because it is very necessary for the breath. As we go up, the quantity of oxygen goes on decreasing. That is why the mountaineers carry oxygen cylinders on their back while climbing high peaks. The astronauts also carry oxygen cylinder for the same reason. Oxygen also helps in burning activity. This is an example of atmosphere. The layer of atmosphere in first one is stratosphere, that is 12 kilometer. Next is stratosphere, that is 50 kilometer. That is next is mesosphere, that is 80 kilometer. The next is thermosphere, that is 700 kilometer, and the last stage is exosphere, that is 10,000 kilometers. The importance of atmosphere. The atmosphere is very important to us. It has many advantages of its own. First one is the atmosphere acts like a blanket or a glass house of the earth. It receives the radiation of sun but does not allow the insulation to escape into space. As such, it keeps the earth warm. Second point, it protects us from the harmful solar radiation. Third point, the water vapor and carbon dioxide present in the lower layer of the atmosphere absorb the heat radiated by the earth's surface, and as such they keep the atmosphere warm every during night. The next is biosphere. Life exists only in a narrow zone where land, water and air come in contact. It is because of this narrow zone called biosphere that our earth is regarded as unique in the whole universe. This zone supports survival varieties of organisms, both plants and animals. There are about 10 lakh varieties of animals and 3 lakh varieties of plants. This is an example of, this is a picture of atmosphere. Layer of the whole domain, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. Lithosphere deals with the sand or crust. Hydrosphere deals with the water, atmosphere deals with the air, and the biosphere deals with the land, air and water. 3. So student Ella have completed with the chapter. If you have any doubt, do a comment on a Facebook or YouTube. Thank you.